to build you on and off the field of play. He's about the community. He's about one great thing that I love to talk about. He's about raising funds. He's about those things. He's about trying to elevate these things. He's building the tool. We have a vision. Mississippi Valley is a special place, and I believe that this is the best choice possible. And I think that he will, and I know that he will. He will show you, he will show us. What we need from you is to continue to support. To my parents, thank you. I promise you, he will. I'm handing them off to your kids, and he will take care of them. We're going to hold them accountable. We're going to push them on and off the field. He's a family man. He got school kids. And I'm not talking about biological. He got a school kid that he looked after. That's his sons that he has coached over the years. He started programs. He's poured into the community and bring those students up. I promise you that we will support baseball. We're believing in baseball. We've already made some steps in trying to increase what things look like. It's going to pour into you, and I hope that you will continue to pour into the student athletes. As I told you, he's a family man. I've known him for quite some time. I know his mom. Appreciate you. We're going to take care of him. and he's going to take care of our student athletes. He comes from a rich, rich tradition in his family. If you don't know who the Bornies are, just look at them. I promise you, you'll understand. He pours that into his students, everyone that's come up behind him. And I told him, he's a family man. So without further ado, Zion, come on up. Bring that hat up to him. He's a family man. He's leading his family. We talked about it. But I want to do it the right way. Bring his son up as he's leading his family to bring the hat the traditional way. Pass the hat on to our new head coach, Milton Bourne.
Last year, he didn't play baseball. That's just because of his grades. And I spent years with him, molding him, and just trying to shape him into the young man he should be, but he didn't play baseball. So that lets you know how important academics are to me. Again, I'm honored to be the seventh baseball coach in this university of great history. Look, for me, just a kid from Gulfport, Mississippi, I'm just honored to be a leader and just an upstanding person in the community. Guys, I'm going to be a role model for you, father figure, because I had a bunch of great people. Without them, I wouldn't be here today. We want to build relationships, and from here, I just want to say another thank you to my administration, Athletic Director, my parents, my family, and to some other people. So right now, I have to my grandmother, who Lola B. McNair, my great aunt, Doris Taylor, who are no longer with us. I just want to say thank you just to the many lessons and principles that they have taught me is part of the reason why I'm here today. To my many mentors, Coach James Cooper, who's with the New York Yankees, I talked to him a lot throughout this process, and it kind of helped me and made it easier for me. Coach Barry Ray, without him giving me the chance to play baseball at Maryland, I don't know where I would be right now today. Last but not least, I have Coach Michael Lindsay. He kind of touched me. Now, this guy was my high school baseball coach. And just a small story, I think I was in the 11th grade playing football and baseball. And I just walked in his office and I said, "Coach, I don't want to play baseball no more." He was like, "Well, let me call your mom, see what she thinks about that." Now, if you know my mom, y'all gonna get to know her because she's just one of those kind of people. She said, "Well, Coach, put him on speakerphone." She said, "Boy, you don't make them kind of decisions." And ever since that day, it kind of just changed me and helped mold me into the person that I am today. Without Coach Lindsay and my mom, that conversation in that office, who knows where I would have been. Baseball saved my life. These great mentors saved my life. And that's what I want to bring here to you all. Just a sense of stability, being able to just come to me. I'm an open book. Of course, you can ask some of the guys that I talked to so far this week. We had no issues. We just talked. Even want to think about the Jalen Holmes. Like we spent about an hour yesterday talking. And we hadn't even scratched the surface. Parents, I want you to know that you can feel comfortable with leaving your kids with me. That's one of your most valuable possessions. It's tough for me. I'm leaving my family. So that lets you know that I'm here to work and I'm here to elevate this program. As I leave you with this. And this verse is Matthew 17:20. I live by this. Truly, I tell you, I have faith as small as a grain of a mustard seed. You say to this mountain, "Move from here to there," and I will move. Nothing will be impossible for you. Thank you.
Okay, at this time we'll be opening up the floor for any questions for Coach Lombardi. Don't be shy if you don't play games.
Y'all sure? Pledge? Parents? I must have been young.
Once again, thank you all. Welcome to Barney and the Barney family. Student athletes, we got a great season ahead of us. Let's get to work. Feel free to come up and take pictures with Coach Barney and ask any questions that you don't want to answer in front of everyone. But once again, welcome. Thank you. Let's elevate.
Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes